In her essay, Illness and Its Metaphors, Susan Sontag explains that, quote, metaphors attached to cancer imply living processes of a particularly resonant and horrid kind, end quote. It is these living processes that Katie Farris writes back to in Standing in the Forest of Being Alive. Written over 2020 to 2021, the text sees Katie Farris chart her experience of breast cancer through diagnosis, chemotherapy, and mastectomy. Farris interweaves personal turmoil against a background of national turmoil as the coronavirus pandemic led to lockdowns, the murder of George Floyd led to Black Lives Matter protests, and the insurrection on the 6th of January at the Capitol led to a crisis in American democracy. Clearly, the nation that Farris is writing about is a nation in mourning, and the body of the individual is intimately connected to the body of the nation. As well as this, though, the collection is also an intimate insight into love and how we relate to our loved ones in times of crisis. The first poem in the collection asks an important question. Why write in the face of personal and national atrocity? It's titled, Why Write Love Poetry in a Burning World? And then goes on to try to answer that question. Why write love poetry in a burning world? To train myself in the midst of a burning world. To offer poems of love to a burning world. The text is full of this kind of self-referential echoing and patterning. So, for example, in the early days of a global pandemic, she writes, Americans are spreading rumors, writing about a country as if a country existed in the midst of a global pandemic. This is then echoed in the last lines of The Invention of America, where she writes, Everyone is writing about a country as if a country existed. This repetition but slight alteration seems to me to be almost like a linguistic entrapment. There's this hopelessness against the systems of power that seek to redefine the struggles of illness, race, and class, but never actually allow any material conditions to change. Farris also continuously writes against the stereotypical perceptions of the cancer patient, so the living processes that Sontag writes about. For example, on the morning of the port surgery, she writes, I'm wheeled into the operating theatre for the opening act of what will become a defining role. Cancer patient, stage 3. Farris's references to kind of theatrical language, the terms act and role, for example, seem to me to be Farris being well aware of the kind of preordained part that individuals are often made to play in the typical narrative of a cancer patient. It's this that she writes against in Woman with Amputated Breast Returns for Her Injection. I can. Watch me can, watch me do, watch me has, watch me watch. This cancer patient has ambition. The wordplay, splitting the word cancer in half and then doubling it, seems to evoke the sense of possibility as the word can becomes a dance. Can, and gives this kind of real sense of slippage from the word cancer to dancer. The demand, I'll not be put in a box. I'll be observed on my own terms. Farris has referred to Emily Dickinson as, quote, the ghost who kind of haunts this book, end quote. And that kind of interaction with the American canon of poetry seems to me to be a kind of reassertion of an identity as an American poet, as distinct from the kind of enforced identity of cancer patient. In a similar way, in an unexpected turn of events midway through chemotherapy, Farris undermines the idea of the living processes by undermining the idea of the desexualized cancer patient. I'd like some sex, please, she asserts, and then proves her command over rhythm in a playful and humorous way. Philosexual, soft and gentle, a real straight fucking, rhymed or metrical, whatever you've got, I'll take it, just so long as we're naked. More generally, I loved the depiction of the relationship that is the kind of central heart to the text. Farris writes with such humor and generosity about the realities of being in a long-term relationship or marriage. And in A Row of Rose, for example, she talks about the kind of disagreements that naturally come as a consequence of that. In general, she writes so warmly about what it means to build a life and to build that life with someone. Standing in the Forest of Being Alive asserts, I'm here and I actively love. It's about what and who and how we choose to love in times of suffering, the intimacies that we build, the love we cultivate in our relationships and in our work, in a world that around us just seems to be in flames.
I'm reading my book.